Good afternoon, everybody. Welcome to a fun-filled, packed episode of Dragon Speed Shop. We'll get a couple more people in here, and then we'll get this all rolling. In the meantime, I'll get this crap shared out. How's everyone's weekend going so far? Got one person out there. My second guys, we'll get this all. All going out. All righty, let's get this going. Today. Going on. Here we go. Mm-hmm. you gotta move. Well, looks like we're getting a couple people tuning in. Welcome everybody. So today we're doing rust on the bug. That's what it did. How's things going for you? How's the family? Working on the JDM build, huh? That's awesome. What are you doing for your JDM build? What car? Subaru? Very nice. Can't go wrong with a good Subaru. So if you guys have watched my videos in the past, you'll know I did a like 32 Ford diorama. This is the same technique that I used on it. As you guys can see this in the background, that's the end result. So we're taking it from what that looks like to this. Jeff, welcome, buddy. We're defiling a bug today. Did this nice, beautiful paint job, and now we're destroying it. Yep, so, as you saw, as you popped in, that's the end result of what it's going to look like. As you guys know, this build is for a competition next year. So I kind of want this thing to stand out by itself. I kind of figured being half shiny and stuff adds character to it. That's right. Yeah, I just want this bug to kind of stand out on its own against all the other bugs that are going to be there. Ron, welcome. I want to keep some parts of this still shiny, other parts all rusted out and stuff like that. Should be a little bit of fun. What am I using for sponge? So this is the Magic Eraser sponge. Usually has two parts, and I just kind of ripped it off, the other half of it. Serious rust, yes. I live in Utah. We get quite a bit of snow, and most of the old cars around here are pretty rusted and gone, so. But it's still shiny. All the salt that gets thrown on the ground around here, it eats cars pretty well. That's when you just plead the fifth and you go, I don't know. I don't know where your cleaning sponges went. It does give it the right texture with this technique. Gonna do a rust job one of these days. You know, they're kind of fun. I actually enjoy them. Grant, what's up? So if you guys haven't seen, this is the rust technique. I can't give you all the secrets to it because the guy I learned it from, I've kind of made a promise to him that I wouldn't show the whole kit and caboodle of how he does it, so. Just out of respect for him. Really nice guy. Does amazing rust jobs, but that's the end result, that hood over there. Same result on the diorama I did. Grant, that truck did turn out pretty sweet. You gonna bring that truck to the UMAG show, Grant? Sweet. It'd be cool to see if you do. I'm hoping to have this bug done by then. Handles. Oh, these? Yeah, I like them. I think they're just the testers that I picked up from Hobby Lobby. They're pretty nice. And they're spring-loaded, so they hold all the parts. They slowly became my favorite things. Funny how it goes from this to this. They're nice. I quite like them. I don't know where my other pair are. My room's a complete and utter disaster right now. Yes, they are made by them, I do believe. Well, the only problem with trying this technique, there's another half to doing this, and I can't tell you what that is. Mike, welcome, bud. It took quite a bit of work to actually get the guy that came up with this idea to let me have it, and just out of respect to him. This is kind of the end result, and I think it looks pretty damn real rust. Ugh. promise I'm not drinking a beer. But I can show you. So I'm using this stuff. This is burnt umber, raw sienna, and this one, barn red. You're pretty happy with that. Mike, welcome, bud. Let's see what I have over here. Oh, come on, open. Yeah, I'll just kind of, the concoction already is kind of rusted up. Takes about 2 or 3 days to actually make this stuff. All right, here comes the magic. Let's see, how am I gonna do this without dripping all over myself? I have to go grab my hair dryer to get this stuff to dry up. Shiny or hold on. Oh, I'm gonna plug some stuff. Shiny or customer rust? All of the above. Where do I have an available plug? Ugh. All right. Sorry if this is loud in your ear. But this is where the magic happens, right before your eyes. So now you can see it actually has some texture, stuff like that. Let's turn on the big light. Oh, where are you plugged? There we go. So this is kind of where all the magic happens, is with this stuff. Well, as soon as this bug is done, and that should be this week, I should have this thing done. My work schedule's kind of lightened up a little bit, so that will give me some time to get this. The boat's been repainted. I had to pick up some more of the white to repaint the top of the boat. The body itself is really, really close to being ready for primer and paint and all that. So that will be coming up shortly. Probably next week, I would say, we're painting. I would say. So as this dries and stuff, it'll actually pick up a lot more color when it's drying and everything. It's kind of always evolving color. That's the nice thing is now, you know, I really don't like this through here. So I can let this dry for about an hour and come back and repat it with the colors and feather it out a little bit more until I get something more like the top of the roof. I'm pretty happy with that. We will see. So you can kind of get different colors with this that I figured out is if I'll let these spots just naturally air dry and you'll end up getting a darker spot. Like right here, I just put, or after I did it and blue dried, I just put this on there and just let it air dry and kind of made it a little bit darker in that spot. So that was kind of cool. The other thing that's nice is right now I can just, so I didn't like those spots. I didn't quite like this. I wanted a little bit more shiny through here. As I can just kind of sit here and rub it with my finger till I actually get what I want. It's not super fragile that you can't hold it, you know, at a competition or something like that. After a few days, this dries pretty well, pretty tight. Mike, you got a video out? Well, let's give Mike a subscribe. Well, I'll have to see. You can kind of see up top that it's starting to dry just a little bit darker there. So I'll have to do that, flip it on the side so the puddle kind of stays right there. Can't figure out how to make one. Any of us, all of us that are in here that have made a YouTube channel, believe me, the first one's the worst. And then it gets a little easier and a little easier, and then eventually you get the harebrained idea to do live streams. And unfortunately now I got a brand new phone. Can you guys tell that the video's any better or audio's any better compared to last live stream? Both? Well, I upgraded the hell out of my phone. Went from a phone that was quite a few years old to the new Note 9. So I may be shooting all my videos with this. Oh, I bought it because of the camera capabilities and all that. Off the board. I didn't notice. Ugh, stuff. Ugh. Everything looks good here. Well, that's good. So, even though you can kind of see just a hair bit of difference, this hood was done yesterday. Yesterday morning. And this, the body, as you saw, is just live. You can see there's just a hair bit of difference. It does kind of lighten up a little bit, so you got to take that into account and everything. But I really do. I really like this rust technique. I've got to talk to him again and see if he's okay if I actually show his concoction that he's come up with, because it's ingenious. But the guy, he's been really, really nice and really, really appreciative. And, you know, I really wanted to learn his rust technique, and talking to him, you know. He is an Australian guy, so communication was day by day, and but really, really super nice. Let's see, where'd my keyboard go? Let's see if I can find him. Let's see this one. Oh, that light is killing me today. Was that his name? Don't remember the guy's name now. Been so long. Let's see. Photos. We'll go to photos. He does an amazing, he's an amazing builder in general. Let's see if I can find him. Give me a second here, guys. know he's been having some health issues lately, so he hasn't posted for a while. You can kind of see that rust just kind of transforming right in front of your eyes on that top of that roof as it dries. Good grief. I don't see any of his builds lately. Ooh, that one. That's not him. Let's see, I know I posted. There he is. So, alright. And I can't pronounce his last name worth anything. So he does a lot better job. Because he's got it kind of perfected. Hold on. Let me fix this light. But this is the same rust technique that I'm using. That's on one of his builds. And that is his name. He is on the Aussie page. But he does a way better job than I do. If you get on Aussie's page and you type his name in, he does have some videos. They're probably going to be way back when, or a long time ago. That you might be able to figure out his rust technique. Right here. I'll show you guys. That's the post. He does have some videos out. You want to learn it. He doesn't go really into depth, but I believe in the videos he shows his actual rust concoction. So, I mean, it's not a trade secret. So, if you guys want to know more or learn more about that, there you go. But I'm not going to tell you. Just out of respect of Dave there. Oh. Let's get this dry and kind of show you what this looks like. So, that's what I'm shooting for. And I will get the rest of this kind of all figured out so it matches that. I'll probably go through and clean some of this stuff up with my fingers. But there you go. So you can see as you left it on there, it kind of put a darker ring around things. Kind of gives it a little bit more rust. You can kind of see when it started to run down the pillar, like, you know, rust water would, kind of left a line running down there. So there's a lot of detail in this rust technique. I think it's, I don't know. I really enjoy it. Maybe next time I do rust, I'll be able to show you the concoction that he's come up with. But guys, we're just about our hour mark. I'm going to keep working on this bug and catch up on your guys' video. So, till next time, guys. This is Dragon Speed Shop. I'm out of here. Hope you guys enjoyed.